Greetings Marines, FiOth here, and in this vid I will be remodding the Halberd. As I stated on stream a few days ago, the Halberd has been totally revamped, increasing its critical hit profile, making it the most suitable assault rifle to be modded for crit. So taking that into consideration, I sat down and thought of a new modding guide for this specific weapon that's now very, very viable and has a very unique profile when it comes to how it should be handled. Without further ado, let's get to it. So here is the Halberd. We all know the drill by now. It is a gun that hits on the lower spectrum when it comes to bullet for bullet damage, but with a higher fire rate, although it boasts one of the smaller magazines. Now, the way I went about is mostly when it concerns usage on higher difficulty settings. We're 3 months into the game's lifespan, so by now we should all be aiming at clearing some of extreme or insane, I suppose. That's my state of mind, at least. So I modded it in a way that will benefit you when you're trying to go up against those settings. Let's take it step by step. So when we go to muzzles, you actually have 3 out of 6 choices that are very, very good. One is ported compensator that gives the game higher fire rate. With everything else combined, it gives you 18.8 bullets per second, which is pretty extreme. It's a very fast firing weapon if you use this. And this is also a flat number, so you don't have to prep it for anything. It just goes as is. The easiest one to use. Second, most approachable but also effective, is the vent break. The vent break gives you 20% more crit damage, setting you up at 265, and gives you plus 5% handling and stability, stacking up to fire times and resetting on reload. 5 out of your 50 bullets will prep this for maximum effect, and you can fire the next 45 bullets with increased stability and handling. The thing is that you get 20%. It's very, very decent, but it is not the best numbers we can hit with this thing. My go-to, my final and best consideration when it comes to using this gun for crit, okay, is the boosted flash hider. It gives it effective range that it really doesn't need, but it gives 40% weak point damage for 5 seconds on kill. That does not stack, but every time you score a kill, you get it back. You have 5 seconds at your disposal. Now, why is this the hardest one to use? On hard difficulty settings, even a runner has a few dozen hundred HP. Okay, on insane, it has 2500 HP. Taking down that initial runner by yourself, if you're, let's say, one-on-one it, it's gonna be a challenge because your damage will be just a tad lacking. After you get the initial kill, after you prep your initial kill, you are able to lay down the damage much more easily with this one. Of course, if you use, let's say, a gunner, it's much more easier to set it up than any other class, because you have overclock at your disposal, or if you're overclocked by someone else, that also helps a lot. It's not like killing a runner, it's hard, don't get me wrong, but in the mess of things, when you try to dodge, when you try to reposition, and so on and so forth, reloading in FTE can be tricky sometimes, and bearing on the enemy can also be tricky. We're not talking about just last stand scenarios at the end of missions. We're talking about traversing 4-1, for example, where you're always attacked by multiple angles. So if you know for a fact that you can get a quick kill on every engagement and keep it going, boosted flash hider is the best choice. That 40% will get you up to 285 with this. It's almost 300% more damage for hitting crits, and that's pretty awesome. Now for the magazine, my choice here is casket for the fire rate and the max ammo. Max ammo brings your capacity up to 810. You're carrying a lot of ammo. You will need a lot of ammo with this gun because it's fast fire rate, relatively low damage, high crit. You will be spewing out a lot of lead, and on higher difficulty settings, you have reduced capacity for ammo. So this fixes the problem of ammo whilst also increasing your rate of fire. If I take this out, we're sitting at 14.1. If I put this on again, it's 16.5. So that's pretty huge for the gun's damage profile. It will help you sustain fire and keep your crit going, and also carry you through the longer stretches where ammo is not available. It is not the only viable solution when it comes to this gun's mags, but for me it's by far the best for the Halberd's updated damage profile. Now for optics, I'm gonna go with something that I don't usually use. I'm gonna get Green Dot, because it has 20% weak point damage and 30% effective range. Now, with the effective range from this and boosted flash hider, the gun is very effective over longer distances, much more so than its fire rate would benefit. Like, you cannot fire this gun full auto the other edge of the map and expect to get results, but it gives it consistency, it gives it a bit of stickiness and responsiveness that wouldn't have been there if we hadn't increased the effective range. Again, it's very minute differences. You're not gonna notice them most of the time, but it's good to have them. What we're going for is the weak point damage though. Sitting at the flash 245, adding the extra 40 when we get it rolling is gonna be a very, very healthy chunk of yellow numbers. I'm gonna demonstrate for a sec why I said that the gunner is probably the best choice, or you should have a gunner when using this. So we're just gonna unload here, and let's say that this nets us a kill. Okay, we have to reload, and its reload animation takes 2 seconds. Okay, we have 5 seconds to score the next kills. We lose 2 of those seconds reloading the gun. If you do not want to spend any slots for this weapon to be more effective, you have to be on point, you have to be playing very aware when it comes to when to reload and how to approach the situation. If you have overclock though, the reload is ridiculously fast, as you can see, and you can unload a lot of bullets. You can literally unload around 3 mags. Now, the setup you need in order to melt the heavies on Extreme and Insane with this weapon is you need to kill anything at all, a facehugger, kill a runner, kill a working jaw, whatever, and then as you have the buff going, you activate your overclock and you have a few seconds to destroy that heavy. So that means you activate overclock just after you kill one target, that can be whatever you want. You activate overclock and then you start hammering, and you have 5 seconds to hammer that heavy really, really hard. If that looks like a lot of work to you and you don't want to be pressured by time all the time with boosted flash hider, just grab vent break and it will serve you really, really well. As I said, this is tricky and it will make hitting large numbers on the hardest targets more difficult, whilst this gives you 20% less, and its activated abilities have to do with handling and stability, but you always have that weak point damage in there. You're always dealing optimal damage when you manage to hit your crits. Okay, either one of those will serve you well. This is mostly for min-maxing and high skill ceiling, and this is a more easygoing, more chill process of mowing through enemies. Pick your poison, and with this kind of numbers here, the gun will serve you really, really well. It's a challenge modding this to its absolute best form, because it has a few things going for it that really have to be considered. For example, this is the fastest firing assault rifle, but it has a magazine of 50, whilst, for example, if we check the pulse rifle, it has a magazine of 60 out of the box. The fire rate can be a bit slower, but it hits for substantially more, and it also has a better crowd control, let's say, capacity because of its stumble chance. It's a very intricate give or take. It's a very intricate min-max scenario with the Halberd, but if modded and used correctly, it can work wonders now, and it has an identity of its own. It's just another gun that shoots a bit faster, but deals a little bit more damage. So, vent break, casket magazine, or if you really want to go hardcore, boosted flash hider, casket, and green dot sight. Hope you found this useful, guys. At the moment, this was the most substantial change to a gun that warranted remodding it, let's say. The minigun just got a flat buff. It didn't really change. So I uploaded a demo guide yesterday for using the minigun to the best of its abilities. The modding guide still holds. For the Halberd is a totally different story. We needed to mod this thing again. Hope my configuration helps you achieve good results. Thank you very, very much for your patronage and for all your support during the streams. We'll be streaming on Monday as always. Sub, like, and share for more content like this. And until next time, be well, stay frosty, and always strive for perfection. Cheers!